Pennsylvania's race for lieutenant governor is getting more attention than usual this year after former Penn State football coach Joe Paterno's son, Jay Paterno, entered the race on the Democratic side.
Jay Paterno has been able to get coverage outside of the basic insider base.
Outside of his time coaching Penn State football and his own last name, many voters know little about Paterno. However, should he make it through to the general election, his presence is sure to bring up past memories many at Penn State University and across the state would rather forget.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt that with Jay Paterno in this race, that it raises the whole question of the Jerry Sandusky sexual abuse case.
And reliving the Sandusky case could dredge up more bad news for incumbent Republican Governor Tom Corbett, who was the Attorney General of Pennsylvania during the Sandusky case. And some have argued that he delayed the sentencing until after his successful run for governor in 2010 to not upset many Pennsylvania voters. And now the state's current Attorney General is looking into whether or not Corbett played politics with his ruling.
That report could be issued at any time, more likely 6 month, 9 month. Imagine that report coming out next September or October.
Governor Corbett may be able to dodge reliving the Sandusky case should Jay Paterno not win in the May primary, and he may be ousted earlier than that, as Paterno's petitions are being challenged in court.
Jay Paterno has petitions that most professionals would consider weekly gathered, in that when you look at them, it's just very hard to see how the court case that's being brought against him is not successful.
Paterno gathered roughly 120 signatures above the 1,000 that are required, leaving him with little wiggle room should some of his petition signatures be found invalid. For WashingtonExaminer.com, I'm Steve Doty.